Hi, everybody. Welcome to our second mini course in machine learning. This section is going to be on unsupervised learning.
That sounds fun. Hi, Michael.
Oh, hey, Charles. I didn't even know you were here.
That's because I'm not really there.
Oh. Well, I'm glad to hear your voice regardless.
Good. I'm always happy to hear your voice, Michael. And I'm looking forward to hearing about unsupervised learning.
Well, unsupervised learning is going to be a series of lectures that we do. But today's lecture is on Pistisminiawa.
Okay.
Which is randomized optimization. I took the letters of optimization and I randomized them.
You're such a nerd. I love it. Okay.
All right. So the plan is to talk about optimization and in particular to focus on some algorithms that use randomization to be more effective. But let's talk a little bit about optimization for a moment because that's something that has come up, but we haven't really spent any time on it. So what I'm thinking about when I talk about optimization, I imagine that there's some input space X, which is, you know, kind of like in the machine learning setting. And we're also given access to an objective function or fitness function F that maps any of the inputs in the input space to a real number, a score. It's sometimes called the fitness, sometimes called the objective, sometimes called score. It can be any of a number of things. But in the setting that we're talking about right now, the goal is to find some value X star in the input space such that the fitness value for that X star is equal to or maybe as close as possible to the maximum possible value.
So that's like argmax then, like we were doing with Bayesian learning.
Yeah, exactly. Right. So of all the possible X's to choose, we'd like to choose the one that causes the function value to be the highest.
Okay.
Yeah, I wrote it this way, though, because I thought it would probably be helpful if it's like, because we'd be pretty happy with an X star that isn't necessarily the best, but it's like near argmax, right? Something that's close to the best.
Okay.
So this is a really important subproblem. It comes up very often. I was wondering if you could think of examples where that might be a good thing to do,
well,
like in life.
Like in life.
Or computation, which is life.
Computation is life, and life is computation. Well, believe it or not, I was actually just talking to someone the other day who works at a chemical plant, and he says there's all these parameters they have to tune in when they mix their little magical chemicals, and if they do it just right, they end up with something that, you know, is exactly the right temperature, comes out just right. If they're wrong at all, if some of their temperature is off a little bit or anything is wrong, then it ends up costing a lot of money and not coming out to be as good as they want it to be. So, you know, factories and chemicals and optimization and parameters.
Factory, chemical. I'm not sure that's a general category of problem, but I guess maybe the one way to think about it is in, we'll call it process control. So if you've got a process that you're trying to put together and you have some way of measuring how well it's going, like yield or cost or something like that, then you could imagine optimizing the process itself to try to improve your score.
Okay. Yeah, I think that's what I meant.
You know, route finding is kind of like this as well, right? So just, you know, find me the best way to get to Georgia.
What about route finding?
Oh, I see what you did there.
Mm-hmm.
So you could think of route finding as being a kind of optimization as well. If you've got a function and you're trying to figure out where it crosses the origin, you might set that up as an optimization problem. You might say, well, of all the different positions I could be in, I want to minimize the distance between the axis and the value at the point where I chose it. Find me the best one, which, you know, is going to be right there.
Actually, you know, when you put it like that, how about neural networks?
Nice. So that's, yeah, let's get it back to the learning setting. So what do you mean by neural networks?
Well, I mean, everything we've been talking about so far, X, you know, is some kind of stand-in for parameters of something, a process or, I don't know, whatever. So if the weights are just parameters of a neural network, then we want to find the X that, I guess, minimizes our error over some training set or upcoming test sets or something.
Yeah, so minimizing error is a kind of optimization. It's not a max in this case, but if we, I guess, negate it, you want to maximize the negative error that it's maximized when the error is zero.
Right.
Cool. Is any other learning-related topics that you can think of that have optimization in them?
Well, I would guess anything with parameters, where some parameters are better than others, and you have some way of measuring how good they are, is an optimization problem.
So decision trees?
Sure.
So what's the parameters there?
They're the order of the nodes, the actual nodes. Like, what's the first node?
Yeah, the whole structure of the tree. So it's not a continuous value like a weight, but it is a structure. We could try to optimize over the structure. There's nothing in the way that I set this up here that makes it so that X has to be continuous or anything like that. We just need a way of mapping inputs to scores.
Okay. So all of machine learning, everything we did in the first third of the class is optimization.
There's some optimization in each of the pieces of it. Yeah, exactly. Because often we say, given this training set, find me a classifier that does well on the training set. And that's an optimization problem.
Hmm.